Slightly later than we expected. The red lights go out here, though, in Le Mans. Moto2 underway here. It's a great start from pole position for Pedro Acosta, the dream launch for the Moto3 world champion. He's already got four or five bike lengths as they sweep through into the Dunlop chicane for the very first time. Good start as well for his IO teammate, Augusto Fernandez, who's already moved up into second place. Jake Dixon, I think, just hanging on to third spot. Acosta's got the hammer down here, big time. A 1:36.532, fastest lap of the Grand Prix already for the number 51 as he sweeps through the Dunlop chicane. Acosta's half a second lead, which looked quite a comfortable margin, has shrunk. Was there a mistake? Oh, Pedro Acosta's gone down. Can you believe it? Pedro Acosta, he's blown a golden chance to win his first race in the Moto2 World Championship. Pedro Acosta loses the front end of that Calex machine down the hill into La Chapelle. That's a big, big blunder from the rookie.
Dreadful first lap for the VR46 team because Celestino Vietti from 18th on the grid has lost ground on the first lap. He's back in 20th.
It's been a very, very tough weekend for Celestino Vietti. Just not had the pace. This is the long lap penalty then that Bo Benschneider had
to take.
He's in
the gravel look.
Yeah, and there's Celestino Vietti. I've got to give credit to Celestino Vietti because his rescue job, his recovery in the second half of this Grand Prix, having lost a whole bunch of time with the early runoff at Garage Fair. A top nine here is not out of the question for Vietti. He's all over the rear tyres of Gonzalez and Stefano Manti, so there's a ninth place up for grabs for him. What a salvage job by the world championship leader Celestino Vietti there on the Mooney VR46 Calex machine. Vietti came from outside the top 20 at one stage to eighth. Bobier looks like he's just a little bit more on the limit than Canet ahead of him and Chantra behind him. The move surely is coming here. Chantra, will it be at turn number 13? He almost runs into the back of Bobier through turn number 12. Is he lining up the move on the American into this penultimate corner?
He
here it comes, it certainly is. There's no way that Bobier can turn in.
Chantra so good on the brakes. He was able to cover that inside line. Bobier's not giving this up yet, though.
Both Chantra and Bobier sliding both tyres. Magnificent stuff. Somkiat Chantra does resist the late pressure to take third from Cam Bobier. It's still a career best fourth place for the Californian. Darren Kinnett has finally made that move. His charge, it might well already be too late with 21 laps to go of this French Grand Prix to get on par with Fernandez and Acosta.
Oh, that's a big move from a long way back from Chantra. Is he going to make it stick? I think he is.
Well, he basically just moved Canet out of the way. There was nothing that Canet could do there. Canet's recovered. He's so good, Canet, in turns one and two. He's got fantastic confidence and corner speed. Another great ride by Aaron Canet there in second place. He's still not fully fit after that big crash in the rain conditions in Portimao. A first win now since Misano 2019 on a plate for Fernandez. Pedro Acosta then has gifted his teammates what looks like a cruise, a Sunday afternoon stroll in the sunshine for Augusto Fernandez. For the first time in this Grand Prix, our runaway leader Fernandez has built up a lead that now is over 7 seconds. This man has not put a foot wrong. He waited for the big, big mistake, the big blunder from his teammate Pedro Acosta when he crashed out of the lead. Augusto Fernandez wins the 2022 French Grand Prix in Moto2. We'll be right back.